And my oldest son was actually on his way to the park. And a woman saw him and she says, "Young man, are you on your way to the park?" And he says, "Yes, ma'am." She said, "Be careful, they're shooting up there." So his first thought was to run home, but then he thought about it. Darius, we called him Bebe. And he says, "Oh wow, Bebe's up there." So he continued on to the park. And when he got here, little did he know that his brother had become a victim. He came to tell me about it, but one of the neighbor kids who was actually here at the park beat him to it, and he rang the bell and he was like, "Miss Brown." And I was like, "The boys are already at the park, you know, I'm watching my shows and everything." So he's like, Darius has been shot. And I'm like, "Darius has been shot?" Like, it just didn't, the two didn't go together. I mean, like, he's a kid, 13. And then I'm thinking, okay, he's been shot. Then I'm thinking maybe a BB gun or something like that. I just never imagined that it would be with a real gun, a real bullet, and that it would take his life.
They say watch and walk real 757, yeah, we made them that shit. Gang say they rolling, baby, I say just don't call in that bitch.
I'm on the foul with the killers, ayy. I promise we don't need no AA. Big ol' just bought on my AK, spinning they block, tryna throw them like baby.
This is what I meant to say to y'all.
Little.
There's been a lot of people having sex off drugs, but not knowing how the person looked when they finally woke up. Because you're getting all Percocets.
Hold on, say that one more time.
People be having sex.
Been having sex off drugs.
Wake up.
Popping, what'd you say, taking drugs?
People been out here having sex.
Right.
With people that they think look like Holly Berry,
okay,
but they really turn like Tom off of Tom and Jerry.
Okay. Now look, with that being said, we've been hearing a lot of talk about Lil J in the county.
Oh, man.
Man,
fucking on transgenders.
He let a motherfucker stretch his rubber band. Now what a rubber band is, no homosexuality. It's your band back there. Mm-hmm. Don't pose the pop.
Hey, man, I gotta speak on this. You know how the down is, Shorty. I'm full of grace. Man, Shorty ain't right. You in?
His rubber band, he got his rubber band stretched. He stretched, he got his rubber band stretched. Lil J, That's Lil G.
Yeah, they say folks was in there fucking up.
No, his name, fuck his name, man. Lil G. Lil J and none of that. We fucked it. We let me just stop playing, man. We put his name out there bogus in the gate. His new name is called Gilo. Fuck saying Geechee or something. He a Gilo. That's the new one. That's somebody that's getting their rubber band stretched, but try to hide between closed line doors and say they didn't get their rubber band stretched. He was there getting his rubber band licked. He done lost his hairline, different strokes of the world. It's all fucked up. But
then
that's
he
his
got
life.
And put some face in his head.
Yeah, then he back rapping, dissing people. I can already see him turn into an open taco shell, split on the curb with ground beef, meat, lettuce, and everything all on the sidewalk. But that ain't me to say nothing about nothing. All I do is just do comedy. Free R. Kelly too, man. They could have gave us probation or something, man. Them little BLs, whatever happened back then, man, that was a long time ago, man. Oh, for them. But at the end of the day, R. Kelly, man, you might as well sign your music over to me, oh, for the grain. I got you. I'm gonna keep your shit moving. Free kills out of there. Just give me your music. I'll put your shit out there. I'll change your shit around. Put that twist to that thing. Damn, R. Kelly, man, you might as well just let me have that music, gang. I ain't gonna even lie to you. I could be on that bitch. We'll give you the city idea. Dead up about to leave. Go ahead and get that shit to me, R. Kelly. You gonna give me a lot of old pussy too. A lot of motherfucking wolf pussy, yo. For the grave with flies and motherfucking spider webs. Spider webs on that thing. Go ahead and sign that thing over to the kills. Or for the, let me go ahead and fuck the streets up one time with that database music.
Bitch ass nigga, pussy boy, nigga.
I remember shit. I remember you.
case of a cold-blooded child killer. Deright Boondoti is now charged with killing a 9-year-old Tyshawn Lee. Today, police shared horrific new details about the murder. And as CBS 2's Mai Martinez reports, the little boy wasn't Doty's only target.
Mr. Doty was an engine of violence on a killing spree with absolutely no sense of humanity.
And police say Doty and two other men, Corey Morgan and Kevin Edwards, were set on killing as many people connected to a rival gang as they could as retaliation for a gang shooting that killed Morgan's brother and wounded his mother.
Shortly after the shooting, Corey Morgan stated that since his brother was killed and his mother had been shot, he was going to kill grandmas, mothers, and children. At one point, Doty set up a surveillance of Tyshawn's grandmother so he could kill her in order to draw out rival gang members.
That's because the three men believe Tyshawn's father was responsible for the shooting that killed Morgan's brother. But the plan changed on November 2nd when the three men spotted Tyshawn playing in Dawes Park. Police say that's where Doty befriended the 9-year-old as he played on the swings.
His original plan was to torture this child by kidnapping and cutting off his fingers and his ears.
But instead, investigators say Doty lured Tyshawn to this nearby alley by promising to buy him whatever he wanted from a store.
Once they reached the middle of the alley, Doty took out a gun and shot Tyshawn multiple times at close range.
And Alvarez says after killing Tyshawn, Doty wanted to go back to the park to shoot all of the kids playing, but he couldn't because Chicago police were already on the scene.
My team made this.
A vicious cycle of gun violence in Chicago. Tyshawn Lee's father is convicted on gun charges. Pierre Stokes was found guilty yesterday of flashing a gun at a woman in 2014. The next year, Stokes was apparently part of a shooting that killed a rival gang member's brother. Just last week, two members of that gang were convicted of killing 9-year-old Tyshawn out of revenge. But after Tyshawn's death, prosecutors say Stokes went on a revenge spree of his own, shooting three people in 2016. He's now waiting to be tried on attempted murder charges.
Now on to other news. The two men convicted of executing 9-year-old Tyshawn Lee will be locked up behind bars for decades. Dwight Boondoti is a convicted trigger man. He was sentenced to 90 years. His accomplice, Corey Morgan, sentenced to 65. Prosecutors say in 2015 they lured Tyshawn Lee into an alley and shot him in order to get at his dad. They said he belonged to a gang that had shot Morgan's mom and brother. A third man, Kevin Edwards, drove the getaway car. He pleaded guilty to murder and was sentenced to 25 years earlier this year.